Welcome to Learning English with Captain Binoy Varakil, Assistant Professor, Department of English, St. Joseph's College, Thevpidi, Kozhikode, Kerala. In fact, we are learning meter, and in the previous videos, we have learned four important meters. We learned the iambic meter, we learned the anapestic meter, the dactylic meter, and of course, the trochaic meter in the previous videos. If any of you miss those videos, please watch those videos and understand how meter is used in poetry, especially English poetry. We know that poetry is, of course, the spontaneous overflow of powerful emotions, recollecting tranquility. This is, in fact, the definition of poetry by William Wordsworth, the greatest romantic poet. Okay, but we know that poetry is not just emotion. Poetry is not just spontaneous overflow of emotion. Poetry has some kind of beautiful and perfect structure. And the very structure of poetry is effected through stanzaic pattern, metrical arrangement, and of course, rhyme or rhyming words and rhyming lines. Rhyme is again very crucial. Besides that, of course, you have emotion there, beautiful expressions and images and all. That is, of course, poetry. Poetry is writer, word picture in melody. Word picture in melody and rhythm is poetry. Okay, and we learn meter and we know what meter is. Meter is, as we all know, the recurrence in regular units of a prominent feature in the sequence of a language. We have a line, and in that line of poetry, you have, of course, a regular metrical arrangement, regular unstressed, unstressed, or stressed, unstressed, such type of a prominent feature repeatedly occurring in a line of poetry is meter. And today we learn a new meter. In fact, it is again important meter. It is the fifth meter we learn, and it is spondite meter. Spondite meter. Spondite is adjective, and the noun is spondy. Spondite meter or spondy. And spondy is again very important meter, and because a lot of great poets, especially poets like Gerard Manley Hopkins, a Jesuit priest, a priest poet, Gerard Manley Hopkins. Okay, Hopkins' poetry is wonderful and it has been praised by a lot of critics and readers and of course people who love poetry. And his poems, most of the poems, like The Wind Hour, is written in the spondaic meter, and it is of course the regular occurrence of successive syllables one after the other, okay, very close to each other, syllables close to each other, successive syllables with approximately equal strong stress. So what is spondaic meter? Spondaic meter is a meter in which you have the occurrence of two stressed syllables, okay, stressed syllable followed by another stressed syllable. Look at this line: good, strong, thick, stupefying, incense, mock. Okay, good is stress. Good, strong, thick, stupefying, incense, mock. Okay, good is stressed, strong is stressed, thick is stressed, stupefying. Okay, so you have one spondy stressed and stressed. Two stressed here, one spondy, thick and stupefying again. All right, another. So you have in this line two spondies. You might ask, what about the rest of the poem? Okay, the rest of the poem is not written in this particular meter or any meter. It is just normal. So in spondite meter, it is necessary that at least 2 feet we have in the meter. Okay, and here we have two in the spondaic meter, and we can say that the prominent arrangement or metrical arrangement or repeated recurrent pattern is of course a pattern of stressed syllables, right? So we can say that it is written in spondaic meter. We have two spondees in this line. Another very good example is from the Hopkins poem Windhour. Dapple dawn drawn foken. Dapple dawn drawn foken. All right. Dapple dawn drawn foken, right? So again, this kind of occurrence is what is known as spondaic meter. Okay, so with this we come to the end of the learning of spondaic meter. I'm requesting, as usual, you are the maker of your life, so improve your skills. There is a writer in you, write some poetry in spondaic meter and see that you too can do that. It is not meant for Shakespeare, it is not meant for William Wordsworth, or it's not meant for Keats alone. We need new poets, all right? And you can be a poet, write poetry, and be a success, be a topper, be a role model. Bring meaning to your life, bring meaning to your family, and be a wonderful person. Thank you so much for listening. May God bless you.